Hello, welcome to another YouTube video. Hope you guys are having a great week. If you're new to my channel, I'm Pavi Arav. I'm a user experience designer at Amazon. If you're again back to my channel, welcome back. Up until now, I've shot 3 videos, which is finding your design profile, writing your resume, and building your portfolio. If you haven't seen any of these videos, do check them out. I'll leave the links down below. But before I actually shot this video, I shot the video on how to search for a job. But then I realized, you know what, I'm actually missing a step, which is writing the cover letter. I think a lot of people don't believe in cover letters. They feel like it's something that recruiters or hiring managers don't look at, and it's really a waste of time. And I don't have an opinion on it, but I do believe that as a beginner or a mid designer, cover letters can be helpful. And they definitely, sometimes you don't even have an option of not having to provide a cover letter, so you have to provide them in most cases. So I think I really wanted to sort of share some knowledge about that as well, in case you have to upload a cover letter. Before I get started on the episode, I just wanted to say thank you so much for all the people who reach out to me on Instagram, and I've been trying to respond to all of you as possible. All of you have a lot of really interesting questions, and it kind of also gives me a lot of ideas on what video to create next. So thank you so much for that. If you have any questions, I'm the most responsive on Instagram. So yeah, let's jump into the video. How to write your cover letter. According to the Society of HR, they have surveyed a lot of organizations for interviews and cover letters, and what they found out is a cover letter needs to have 3 basic things: how your work experience meets the job requirements, the company you're applying to, they have their responsibilities and job requirements. How does your experience meet those requirements? How does your skills meet those requirements? That's really important as well. And why do you want to work there? I think your cover letter should cover these 3 things for sure. How your work experience meets their requirements, how your skills meets their requirements, and why you want to work there. If there is a particular company which you really want to work for, I think you should make sure to show that in your cover letter. Just kind of put in those keywords, those words that they're really looking for. A lot of these job descriptions and responsibilities, they have a lot of detailed requirements and detailed role descriptions. So make sure what they have put on there is matching with your skill set, and that is something that you're doing as well. And make sure to add them in your cover letter and your resume, so that they know that you are the candidate that they're looking for, and they will definitely call you for the interview. And show how or what problems you've solved. So obviously you must be going through a lot of problems in your day-to-day life, in your work, and as a designer you should be solving those problems, you should be dealing with them. So how do you go about doing that? Even give some examples on what problems you've solved, and give examples of what projects you've worked on, what impact or it has had on the business and the customer. I think like I've mentioned in my portfolio and resume videos, showing the impact, showing those success metrics really matters. So do that on your cover letter as well. And also kind of convey in the cover letter what you believe in. Research about the company, know about what they believe in, what their culture is, what is something that they really stand up for and look out for in a candidate. Research about that about the company, and put them in your cover letter as well. I'm sure there are some things what they believe in, you must believe in it as well. So make sure you convey that tone, you convey that message in the cover letter, so that they know that, you know, this is what we are looking for as well. So we really think we are a good fit, so they feel that way. So definitely do that. And also tell your story. How did you get to where you are? Like, how did you, what are the different things you worked on? What are the different skills you've collected along the way? What are the different certifications and problems you've solved. So kind of list out your story, but make sure it's very relevant to the company you're applying to. Make sure it aligns with what they are looking for. You can't just randomly share a story and expect it to click with them when it's not even related. So share a story which is relatable to them. Share a problem that they are trying to solve, that they are looking to get some help on. So kind of do a lot of research on the company before you write your cover letter, so you can convey all that, all what they're looking for in your cover letter. And also towards the end of the cover letter, always have call to action. Basically say, you know, give out your email ID, your phone number or your portfolio or anything of that sort. Make sure you give them a reason to contact you, and also you give them a way to contact you, because they really need to know where to reach out to you immediately if they really like you. So definitely do that. So I think these five things are the key things you need to add in your cover letter: how your work experience meets the job requirements, how your skills meets the job requirements, why you want to work there, show how or what problems you solve, show that you actually believe in their culture and believe in their goal and their mission. Tell your story, like what made you get there, and tell them why your story is relatable to their story. Make sure it kind of you understand what they're going through, and make sure you know what problems they're going through and how you can solve them. And also give some call to action so that they can reach out to you if they think you're the right candidate, you're the right fit, and they want to reach out to you. Make sure it's really easy for them to do that. So these are just a few things. It's not much. Cover letters, I mean, I still believe you have to keep it short. Make it very brief, very short, so that, you know, it's not two pages and, you know, paragraphs and paragraphs. So the recruiters definitely don't have the time to sort of go through that and read everything. Just have some key buzzwords, key things, key highlights, and, you know, make it short and brief, one pager only, lesser than a page. I think less than a page, 3/4 of a page is an optimal amount. Make sure you address them in the right way. Keep it very professional. Keep it very, you know, to the point, and don't go on like a big rant. And also definitely tell them why you would be good for the job. Tell them how you can help them, and just kind of really convey why you want to work there. I'm sure if you're putting in the effort to write a cover letter, I'm sure you really want to work for this company. So definitely make sure you also do the part of researching, because getting an interview is the most, I feel, is the most hardest thing of the entire job search process, the job interviews and everything. Even preparing for interview, I feel, is still in your hands. If you're hardworking enough, if you're passionate enough, it really, you can crack that interview. But getting that interview is the toughest thing, because it's sometimes it depends on luck, sometimes it depends on the moment you're in, and, you know, the right place, the right time, and it really depends on a lot of different factors. It's not something that only you can control. So I think getting an interview is something you want to make sure you're playing all the cards right and hoping that you can get the interview. So, but yeah, I hope you get some inspiration and some ideas from this. If you have any questions about the cover letter, please feel free to reach out to me on Instagram and ask me any questions you have, or you can also leave them down in the comments below. Or if you wanted to email me, you can email me at paviara4@gmail.com, and I'll reach out and I will respond there as well. But yeah, I see you again next week. If you like this video, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe so that every time I post a video, you get notified. Actually, you know what I realized? If you subscribe, you don't really get notified. It just kind of pops up in your subscriptions. But if you click that bell icon, you will get notified. So click on that bell icon as well. And I'll see you again next week. Have a great one, and happy cover lettering, I think. I don't know. Yeah, but have fun doing that. And I'll see you again next week. Bye.